Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ. And welcome to this live-streamed broadcast of the Holy Father's general audience for today, Wednesday, December 30th, 2020, and the last general audience of the year due to the coronavirus measures enforced here. This transmission is coming to you live from the Library of the Apostolic Palace. From wherever you are joining us, I'd like to welcome you to this live broadcast. Some of you may be joining us through the various Vatican media channels, perhaps the Vatican audio or radio app, the Vatican News web portal, or our YouTube channel. And to all of you joining us through We Are One Body Radio, Radio Luce, Radio Maria, Radio Horeb, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Catholic TV, Luminous Radio in India, and at Madrashan TV, as well as Radio Maria Papua New Guinea. Welcome one and all, and to all of you joining us through radio stations and other internet sites throughout the world. Thank you for joining us. My name is Christopher Wells, and I will be offering you a translation of the Holy Father's Catechesis this morning. We do want to thank you all for joining us.
Il Santo Padre dà ora inizio all'udienza generale, introducendola con il segno della croce e il saluto liturgico. Disponiamoci ad accogliere la sua parola e a ricevere la sua benedizione.
Nel nome del Padre, del Figlio e dello Spirito Santo. La pace sia con voi.
And the Father begins the audience with the sign of the cross and the liturgical greeting. Now we'll hear a few words of greeting in the various languages of the audience.
Paolo Apostolo ai Tessalonicesi. Fratelli, siate sempre lieti, pregate ininterrottamente, in ogni cosa rendete grazie. Questa infatti è la volontà di Dio in Cristo Gesù verso di voi. Non spegnete lo spirito. Parola di Dio.
De la première lettre de Saint Paul apôtre aux Thessaloniciens. Frères, soyez toujours dans la joie, priez sans relâche, rendez grâce en toutes circonstances. C'est la volonté de Dieu à votre égard dans le Christ Jésus. N'éteignez pas l'esprit. Parole du Seigneur.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Thessalonians. Brethren, rejoice always, pray constantly, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
And you heard the reading from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 through 19, which will be the basis of the Holy Father's reflections. We've already heard the reading in French and English. We will also hear German, Portuguese, Spanish, Arabic, Polish, and of course, originally in Italian. And for those of you who are familiar with the audience, the audience is done in several major languages of the world, and the reading is repeated. The Holy Father gives somewhat extended catechesis in Italian. He has been speaking in recent weeks on prayer, and today's topic is the prayer of thanksgiving. After the Holy Father's catechesis in Italian, There is a brief summary in the other languages, followed by the Holy Father's greeting to the various language groups, which he pronounces in Italian and then is repeated by the speakers in their native tongues. At the conclusion of the audience, of course, the Holy Father will lead us in praying the Our Father, and then give us his blessing, which is extended to everyone listening in live to the broadcast, as well as to our families and loved ones. And so as the readings continue, we prepare ourselves to hear the words of the Holy Father.
أيها الإخوة افرحوا دائما لا تكفوا عن الصلاة اشكروا على كل حال فتلك مشيئة الله لكم في المسيح يسوع لا تخمد الروح كلام الرب.
Z pierwszego listu świętego Pawła apostoła do Tesaloniczan. Bracia, zawsze się radujcie, nieustannie się módlcie, w każdym położeniu dziękujcie. Taka jest bowiem wola Boża w Jezusie Chrystusie względem was. Ducha nie gaście. Oto Słowo Boże.
Cari fratelli e sorelle.
Now the words of our Holy Father. Dear brothers and sisters, good morning. Today I would like to focus on the prayer of thanksgiving, and I take my cue from an episode recounted by the evangelist St. Luke. While Jesus was on the way, 10 lepers approached him who begged him, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. We know that those who had leprosy suffered not only physically, but also from social and religious marginalization. They were marginalized. Jesus did not back off from meeting them. Sometimes he surpassed the limitations imposed by the law and touched, embraced, and healed the sick person. In this case, there was no contact. From a distance, Jesus invited them to present themselves to the priests, who were designated by law to certify healings that had occurred. Jesus said nothing else. He heard their prayer, their cry for mercy, and he sent them immediately to the priests. Those lepers trusted him. In the moment of healing, they trusted him and they went immediately. They went immediately, and while they were on their way, they were cured, all 10 of them. The priest would therefore have been able to verify their healing and readmit them to normal life. But this is where the important point enters in. Only one in the group, before going to the priests, returned to thank Jesus and to praise God for the grace received. And Jesus points out that the man was a Samaritan. He was not a Jew. He was a sort of heretic for the Jews of the time. Jesus comments, was no one found to return and give grace and give praise to God except this foreigner?
E questo racconto, per così dire, divide il mondo in due. Chi non ringrazia e chi ringrazia.
This narrative, so to speak, divides the world in two, those who do not give thanks and those who do, those who take everything as if it is owed them and those who welcome everything as a gift, as a grace. The Catechism says, every event and need can become an offering of thanksgiving. The prayer of thanksgiving always begins here, to recognize that grace precedes us. We were thought of before we learned how to think. We were loved before we learned how to love. We were desired before our hearts conceived a desire. If we view life like this, then thank you becomes the driving force of our day. Thank you. We can never forget to say thank you. For us Christians, thanksgiving was the name given to the most essential sacrament there is, the Eucharist. In fact, the word in Greek means precisely this, thanksgiving. Christians, as all believers, bless God for the gift of life. To live is above all to have received. To live is to have received, to have received life. All of us are born because someone wanted us to have life. And this is only the first of a long series of debts that we incur by living. Debts of gratitude. During our lives, more than one person has gazed on us with pure eyes, gratuitously. Often these people are educators, catechists, persons who carried out their roles above and beyond what was required of them. And they provoked in us gratitude. Even friendship is a gift for which we should always be grateful. This gratitude that Christians share with everyone grows in meeting Jesus. The Gospels attest that when Jesus passed by, he often provoked joy and praise to God in those whom he met. The Gospel accounts are filled with prayerful people who are touched by the coming of the Savior, and we too are called to participate in this immense jubilation.
E anche noi siamo stati chiamati a partecipare di questo immenso tripudio. Lo suggerisce anche l'episodio dei 10 lebbrosi guariti.
The episode of the 10 lepers who are healed also suggests this.
Tutti erano felici per aver recuperato.
Naturally, all of them were happy to have recovered their health, allowing them to end that unending forced quarantine
che li escludeva dalla comunità.
That excluded them from the community.
Ce n'è uno.
But among them, there was only one who experienced an additional joy. In addition to being healed, he rejoices at meeting Jesus. He is not only freed from evil, but he now possesses the certainty of being loved. And this little nugget, you give thanks, expresses the essence of being loved, this great step, the certainty of being loved. It is the discovery of love as the force that governs the world. As Dante said, the love that moves the sun and other stars. We are no longer vagabonds wandering aimlessly here and there. No, we have a home. We dwell in Christ. And from that dwelling, we contemplate the rest of the world, which appears infinitely more beautiful to us. We are children of love. We are brothers of love. We are men and women of grace and thanksgiving. Therefore, brothers and sisters, let us seek to remain always in the joy of encountering Jesus. Let us cultivate joyfulness. The devil, instead, after having deluded us, leaves us sad and alone. If we are in Christ, there is no sin and no threat that can ever prevent us from continuing joyfully on our way, together with many other companions on the road. Above all, let us not forget to give thanks. If we are bearers of gratitude, the world will become better, even if only a little bit. But a little bit is enough to transmit a bit of hope. We have need of hope and of thanksgiving. And without gratitude, we can't transmit this hope. Everything is united and connected. And everyone needs to do his or her part wherever they are. The path to happiness is the one St. Paul described at the end of one of his letters. Pray constantly. We give thanks in all circumstances. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the Spirit. Don't quench the Spirit. Have this program of life. Thank you. The words of our Holy Father based on the reading that we have heard. And now we're going to hear the greetings of the various language groups to the Holy Father. And we're hearing here French first. The speaker greets the Holy Father, Pope Francis, in the name of all the speakers of the various languages, and then offers a brief summary of the Holy Father's catechesis in their own language. Again, as we said, at the end of that summary, the Holy Father will say a few words in Italian to the speakers of the various languages, which then will be repeated in their own languages by the speakers.
Entre les personnes qui remercient et celles qui ne le font pas, celles pour qui tout est dû et celles pour qui tout est don. Or, tout événement et même toute nécessité peut devenir un motif de remerciement. En toute chose, nous sommes précédés par la grâce. Le reconnaître est au point de départ de la prière de remerciement. L'action de grâce culmine dans la vie du chrétien par la célébration du plus grand des sacrements, l'Eucharistie, qui signifie justement cela, remercier. Vivre, c'est tout recevoir de Dieu et l'en remercier, et ce merci se dilate dans la rencontre avec Jésus. Le lépreux reconnaissant de l'Évangile ne se contente pas de la joie d'avoir été guéri, mais de la certitude d'être aimé par lui. Si nous appartenons au Christ, aucun péché ni aucune menace ne pourra jamais nous empêcher de continuer notre route dans la joie. Comme le dit saint Paul, priez sans relâche et rendez grâce en toutes circonstances, c'est la volonté de Dieu à votre égard dans le Christ Jésus. Et maintenant, sa sainteté va saluer en italien les francophones.
Saluto cordialmente i fedeli di lingua francese, fratelli e sorelle. Il mistero del Natale che abbiamo celebrato ci mantenga nella gioia dell'incontro con Gesù. Possa questo incontro illuminare il nostro cammino per tutto il prossimo anno. Dio vi benedica.
Vous saluant en italien, le Saint-Père vient de dire: je salue cordialement les personnes de langue française.
I cordially greet the faithful of the French language. Brothers and sisters, may the mystery of Christmas that we have celebrated keep us in the joy of encountering Jesus. May this encounter enlighten our path for the whole year to come. May God bless you. And now we'll have the greetings for English speakers.
Most Holy Father, the English-speaking faithful joining us through the media wish to express to you their sentiments of respect and esteem and best wishes for the new year, and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Peter. At the end of the audience, we will recite together the Our Father in Latin. The Holy Father will then impart his apostolic blessing, which he willingly extends to all children and young people, the elderly and the sick. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's words this morning. Dear brothers and sisters, as part of our continuing catechesis on prayer, we now turn to the prayer of thanksgiving. Saint Luke tells us that of the 10 lepers healed by Jesus, only one came back to thank the Lord. This passage reminds us of the importance of gratitude. It shows the great difference between hearts that are thankful and those that are not, between people who see everything as their entitlement and those who receive everything as grace. As Christians, our prayer of thanksgiving is inspired by gratitude for the love of God revealed in the coming of Jesus, his Son and our Savior. The gospel accounts of Christ's birth show us how the coming of the Messiah was welcomed by hearts that trusted and prayed for the fulfillment of God's promises. May our celebration of this Christmas season be marked by fervent prayer of thanksgiving for the outpouring of God's redemptive grace upon our world. May these prayers enlarge our hearts and enable us to bring the hope and joy of the gospel to all around us, especially to our brothers and sisters most in need. The Holy Father will now greet the English-speaking faithful in Italian.
Saluto cordialmente I fedeli di lingua inglese. A ciascuno di voi, alle vostre famiglie, auguro di custodire la gioia di questo tempo di Natale, incontrando nella preghiera il Salvatore che desidera farsi vicino a tutti. Dio vi benedica.
I cordially greet the English-speaking faithful. May each of you and your families cherish the joy of this Christmas season and draw near in prayer to the Savior who has come to dwell among us. God bless you.
And that was the Holy Father's greetings to the English-speaking faithful. We'll now hear German.
Heiliger Vater, die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache, die über Rundfunk und Internet teilnehmen, freuen sich, Ihnen, dem Nachfolger des heiligen Petrus, an der Schwelle zum neuen Jahr ihre besten Wünsche zu übermitteln. Zugleich bekunden sie Ihnen ihre aufrichtige Verbundenheit, Dankbarkeit und Verehrung. Sie versichern Sie gerne Ihres Gebets für Ihre Person und in allen Anliegen Ihres apostolischen Dienstes als Hirte der universalen Kirche. Zum Schluss dieser Audienz beten wir gemeinsam das Vaterunser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater allen den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kranken, die Kinder und die älteren Menschen. Es folgt eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, im Rahmen unserer Katechesen zum Thema des Gebets blicken wir heute auf das Dankgebet. Manchmal tun Menschen sich schwer mit dem Danken, weil sie meinen, sie hätten sozusagen ein Anrecht auf das Gute, das ihnen widerfährt. Viele jedoch gelangen zu der entscheidenden Erkenntnis, dass letztlich alles Geschenk, ja Gnade ist. Ehe wir denken konnten, wurden wir gedacht. Ehe wir lernten zu lieben, wurden wir geliebt. Wir verdanken uns nicht uns selbst. Leben heißt vor allem, empfangen zu haben. So verdanken wir uns unseren Eltern, Erziehern, Freunden und vielen anderen Menschen, ohne die wir nicht dieselben wären, die wir heute sind. Im Letzten aber verdanken wir uns Gott. Seine Gnade geht allem voraus und was uns auch widerfährt, wir haben immer Grund zu danken. Nicht von ungefähr ist für uns Christen das wesentlichste Sakrament das der Danksagung, die Eucharistie. In der Begegnung mit Jesus erfährt der Mensch, dass er bedingungslos geliebt ist. Und diese Liebe verwandelt, wie uns die verschiedenen Abschnitte der Evangelien, die wir jetzt in der Weihnachtszeit hören, bezeugen. Auch wir sind berufen, in seiner Liebe die Kraft zu erkennen, die die Welt regiert. Wir irren nicht mehr plan- und ziellos umher. Wir haben in Christus eine Heimat, einen festen Bezugspunkt und von da aus erscheint uns alles noch einmal so viel schöner. Dankbarkeit ist der tiefste Grund der Freude.
Cari fratelli e sorelle di lingua tedesca, alla fine di questo anno difficile siamo forse tentati di vedere anzitutto ciò che non era possibile fare e ciò che ci mancava. Ma non dimentichiamo le tante innumerevoli ragioni per cui ringraziare Dio e i nostri vicini. Vi auguro di cuore la gioia che nasce dalla gratitudine.
Liebe Brüder und Schwestern deutscher Sprache.
Dear brothers and sisters of the German language, at the end of this difficult year, we are perhaps tempted to see, first of all, what was not possible and all that we lacked. Let us not forget the many countless reasons we have to thank God and our fellow human beings. I sincerely wish you the joy that comes from gratitude.
Santo Padre, los fieles de lengua española que siguen esta catequesis a través de los medios de comunicación.
The greetings from the Spanish speakers. The Holy Father will himself give a summary of his catechesis, which we'll let you listen to here in just a moment. And then there's the greetings to the Spanish-speaking faithful.
Después el Santo Padre impartirá la bendición apostólica, de modo particular a los niños, a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, hoy reflexionamos sobre la oración de acción de gracias. El evangelista Lucas nos relata cómo Jesús curó 10 leprosos, pero solo uno de ellos volvió a darle gracias. Precisamente un samaritano, considerado hereje por los judíos. En esa ocasión Jesús comentó, solo este extranjero volvió para glorificar a Dios. Así nos muestra cómo el mundo puede dividirse en dos tipos de personas, los que dan gracias y los que creen que todo se les debe. La oración de acción de gracias nace precisamente de sentir que todo lo que tenemos es un regalo, un don, que estamos vivos, porque alguien nos ha querido antes incluso que nosotros aprendiéramos a pensar, aprendiéramos a amar o a desear. Los cristianos hemos dado el nombre de Eucaristía, que en griego dice acción de gracias, al principal sacramento de nuestra fe. Nosotros damos gracias por la vida y por todo lo que ella nos da. Pero como el leproso samaritano, no solo agradecemos los dones, sino en ellos el encuentro con Jesús. Ese leproso se distinguió de los otros porque entendió que debía dar gracias por su curación, pero sobre todo por haber conocido cuánto lo amaba Jesús. También nosotros estamos llamados a ser testigos con la acción de gracias de esa alegría, pues estamos encontrando una casa donde nos divertimos y acogidos amados. El demonio busca alejarnos, dejarnos solos y tristes. Sin embargo, no estamos solos. Con Jesús podemos estar siempre alegres, porque nada puede separarnos de su amor.
The greetings.
Saludo cordialmente a los fieles de lengua española. Los animo a responder esta alegría del encuentro con Jesús, como nos pide el apóstol San Pablo, dando gracias en cualquier situación y siendo perseverantes en la oración. Y a todos les deseo un año nuevo lleno de la presencia misericordiosa de Dios. Que el Señor los bendiga.
I cordially greet the Spanish-speaking faithful. I encourage you to respond to this joy of the encounter with Jesus as the Apostle Paul asks of us, giving thanks in every situation and being persevering in prayer. And to all of you, I wish a new year full of the merciful presence of God. May the Lord bless you. We just heard the Holy Father's catechesis summary in Spanish with his greeting to Spanish-speaking faithful, and now we'll hear the Portuguese summary of the catechesis.
Após a oração, o Santo Padre nos concederá a bênção apostólica, de modo especial, às crianças, aos idosos, aos doentes e a todos os que sofrem. Leio agora um resumo da catequese do Papa Francisco. No Evangelho de São Lucas, lê-se que 10 leprosos vêm ao encontro do Senhor implorando: Jesus, Mestre, tem compaixão de nós. Nosso Senhor escuta o seu grito e lhes envia aos sacerdotes, que tinham a função de comprovar a realidade da cura. No caminho, todos os 10 resultam curados. E aqui vem o ponto mais importante. Somente um retorna para agradecer a Jesus. Esta narrativa, por assim dizer, divide as pessoas em 2 tipos: aquelas que não agradecem e aquelas que agradecem. Aquelas que recebem tudo como algo que lhes fosse devido e aquelas que acolhem tudo como dom, como graça. A oração de agradecimento começa sempre a partir do reconhecimento de que fomos precedidos pela graça. Alguém pensou em nós antes que pudéssemos pensar. Fomos amados antes que pudéssemos amar. Fomos desejados antes que o nosso coração fosse capaz de expressar um desejo. Se olhamos para a vida deste modo, então, o obrigado torna-se o tema guia das nossas jornadas. Para nós cristãos, a ação de graças deu nome ao mais essencial dos sacramentos, a Eucaristia. De fato, o vocábulo grego significa precisamente isto: agradecimento. Os cristãos, como todos os demais crentes, bendizem a Deus pelo dom da vida. Viver é, antes de tudo, haver recebido um dom. Este obrigado que o cristão compartilha com os demais dilata-se ainda mais no encontro com Jesus, como nos atesta o episódio dos 10 leprosos curados. Naturalmente, todos experimentavam a alegria de ter sido curados, de poder sair daquela interminável quarentena a qual eram forçados. Mas houve um que, a esta alegria, uniu outra, a de ter encontrado Jesus. Não somente foi libertado do mal, mas possui agora a certeza de ser amado. De igual modo, procuremos sempre a alegria do encontro com Jesus e, sobretudo, não esqueçamos de agradecer. Se somos portadores de gratidão, o mundo se torna um lugar melhor. Agora o Santo Padre saudará em italiano os fiéis de língua portuguesa.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, domenica scorsa abbiamo celebrato la festa della Santa Famiglia. Da San Giuseppe e dalla Vergine Maria, che hanno custodito con tanto amore il bambino Gesù, impariamo ad amare sempre di più coloro che Dio ci ha affidato. Vi benedico di cuore, augurandovi un sereno e felice anno nuovo.
Eis a tradução das suas palavras.
Dear brothers and sisters, last Sunday we celebrated the Feast of the Holy Family. From St. Joseph and the Virgin Mary, who always protected the child Jesus with such love, we learn to always love those whom God has entrusted to us. I bless you from the heart, wishing you a peaceful and happy New Year.
أيها الأب الأقدس يسر المؤمنون الناطقون باللغة العربية الذين يتابعوننا عبر وسائل التواصل الاجتماعي.
And now we're hearing the greetings of the Arabic speaking faithful, excuse me.
ويتمنون لكم أيضا سنة جديدة سعيدة. إنهم يؤكدون صلاتهم لقداستكم ولشخصكم ولخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنتلو صلاة الأبانا باللغة اللاتينية ثم سيمنح قداسة البابا البركة الرسولية وخاصة الأطفال والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين. إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس. تأمل قداسة البابا اليوم في صلاة الشكر من خلال حادثة شفاء 10 برص قال: بينما كان يسوع في طريقه جاء 10 برص للقائه وتوسلوا إليه ليشفيهم. لم يقل لهم شيئا بل أصغى إلى صلاتهم وصراخهم وأرسلهم في الحال إلى الكهنة. وفي أثناء ذهابهم شفوا جميعهم، لكن واحدا فقط عاد إلى يسوع قبل أن يذهب إلى الكهنة ليشكره ويحمد الله على نعمة الشفاء التي نالها. كان سامريا وغريبا بالنسبة لليهود، هو الذي عاد ليشكر. يقول قداسة البابا: هذا الحدث يقسم العالم إلى قسمين، من يشكر ومن لا يشكر. مع أن كل حدث وكل احتياج في حياتنا يمكن أن يكون سبباً للشكر على كل نعمة أعطيت لنا حتى قبل أن نطلبها. وكلمة الشكر هذه التي يشارك فيها المسيحيون مع الجميع في اللقاء مع يسوع تتخذ أبعاداً وحجماً أرحب. في الواقع تشهد الأناجيل على أن يسوع غالباً ما أثار الفرح مع الشكر والحمد لله في الذين قابلوه، كما حدث مع الأبرص الذي عاد بعد شفائه ليشكر وليفرح بلقائه مع يسوع، لأنه تيقن أنه التقى إنساناً يحبه. ونحن أيضاً مدعوون أن نشكر وأن نشارك في فرح اللقاء مع يسوع، فلنحاول أن نبقى دائماً في هذا الفرح، لأنه إذا كنا في المسيح فلا خطيئة ولا تهديد يمكن أن يمنعنا أبداً من أن نواصل مسيرتنا بفرح مع رفقائنا على الطريق. والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين اللغة العربية.
Saluti fedeli di lingua araba. La strada della felicità è quella che San Paolo ha descritto alla fine di una delle sue lettere. Pregate ininterrottamente. Ogni cosa rendete grazie. Questa infatti è la volontà di Dio in Cristo Gesù verso di voi. Non spegnete lo spirito. Auguro a tutti un felice anno nuovo.
I greet the faithful of the Arabic language. The path of happiness is that which St. Paul described at the end of one of his letters. Pray constantly. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the Spirit. I wish everyone a happy new year. Now for the greetings in Polish.
Ojcze Święty, wierni w Polsce i w innych krajach, którzy jednoczą się z nami za pośrednictwem środków przekazu, pragną złożyć Waszej świątobliwości wyrazy czci i oddania oraz najserdeczniejsze życzenia szczęśliwego, błogosławionego Nowego Roku. Zapewniają też o swojej modlitwie we wszystkich intencjach związanych z posługą następcy Piotra. Na zakończenie audiencji odmówimy wspólnie modlitwę Ojcze Nasz po łacinie. Następnie Ojciec Święty udzieli swojego błogosławieństwa, obejmując nim szczególnie dzieci, młodzież, osoby w podeszłym wieku i dotknięte cierpieniem. Dzisiejsza katecheza poświęcona jest modlitwie dziękczynienia. Ojciec Święty wychodzi od ewangelijnej historii uzdrowienia 10 trędowatych, z których tylko jeden, Samarytanin, wrócił, aby podziękować Jezusowi i uwielbić Boga za otrzymaną łaskę. Opowiadanie o tym zdarzeniu pokazuje, że ludzie dzielą się na tych, którzy nie dziękują i tych, którzy to czynią. Tych, którzy wszystko przyjmują, jakby im się to należało i tych, którzy przyjmują wszystko jako dar, jako łaskę. W katechizmie czytamy: każde wydarzenie, każda potrzeba może stać się przedmiotem dziękczynienia. Modlitwa dziękczynienia zawsze zaczyna się w tym miejscu, od uznania, że poprzedza nas łaska. Zostaliśmy pomyślani, zanim nauczyliśmy się myśleć. Zostaliśmy pokochani, zanim nauczyliśmy się kochać. Byliśmy upragnieni, zanim pragnienie pojawiło się w naszych sercach. Jeśli w ten sposób spojrzymy na życie, to wówczas dziękuję stanie się motywem przewodnim naszych dni. Dla nas chrześcijan szczególnym wyrazem dziękczynienia jest sakrament Eucharystii. Chrześcijańskie dziękuję poszerza się w spotkaniu z Jezusem. Ewangelie świadczą o tym, że przejście Jezusa często wzbudzało radość i uwielbienie Boga w tych, którzy Go spotkali. Sugeruje to również wydarzenie uzdrowienia 10 trędowatych. Oczywiście wszyscy oni byli szczęśliwi, że odzyskali zdrowie, dzięki czemu mogli wyjść z tej niekończącej się przymusowej kwarantanny, która wykluczyła ich ze społeczności. Ale wśród nich był jeden, który do radości przydawał radość. Oprócz uzdrowienia cieszył się ze spotkania z Jezusem. Nie tylko został uwolniony od zła, ale teraz ma również pewność, że jest kochany. Jest to odkrycie miłości jako siły rządzącej światem. Jeśli jesteśmy w Chrystusie, żaden grzech i żadna porażka nie może powstrzymać nas od kontynuowania naszej podróży z radością wraz z wieloma towarzyszami drogi. Zatem nie zaniedbujmy dziękczynienia. Jeśli niesiemy wdzięczność, to i świat staje się lepszy, bogatszy w nadzieję.
And the Pope's greeting.
Saluto a tutti i polacchi. Cari fratelli e sorelle, avvicinandoci alla fine di quest'anno, non lo valutiamo solo attraverso le sofferenze, le difficoltà e i limiti causati dalla pandemia. Scorgiamo il bene ricevuto in ogni giorno, come pure la vicinanza e la benevolenza degli uomini, l'amore dei nostri cari e la bontà di tutti coloro che ci circondano. Ringraziamo il Signore per ogni grazia ricevuta e guardiamo con fiducia e con speranza al futuro, affidandoci all'intercessione di San Giuseppe, patrono dell'anno nuovo. Sia per ciascuno di voi e per le vostre famiglie un anno felice e pieno di grazie divine. Il Signore vi benedica.
I offer cordial greetings to all the Poles. Dear brothers and sisters, as we approach the end of this year, let us not assess it only through the sufferings, the difficulties, and the limitations caused by the pandemic. We see the good received each day, as well as the closeness and benevolence of people, the love of those who are dear to us, and the goodness of all those around us. Let us thank the Lord for every grace received, and look with confidence and hope to the future, entrusting ourselves to the intercession of Saint Joseph, patron of the new year. May it be for each of you and for your families a happy year filled with divine graces. May the Lord bless you. Finally, the Holy Father will greet the Italian speakers and will offer a translation of those remarks.
Desiderano porgerle cordiali auguri per il nuovo anno. Rinnovano l'espressione della loro sincera devozione e filiale gratitudine ed assicurano fervide preghiere per tutte le intenzioni del suo universale ministero apostolico. A conclusione di questa udienza reciteremo la preghiera del Padre Nostro in latino, terminata la quale il Santo
Holy Father, of course, does not summarize the catechesis, which was delivered in Italian, and simply greets the faithful. First, however, there's an appeal. Yesterday, an earthquake in Croatia caused victims and serious damage. I express my closeness to those who lost their lives and my closeness for their families. I hope that the country's leaders, helped by the international community, might be able to quickly alleviate the suffering of the dear Croatian population. And now the greetings for the Italian speakers. I offer cordial greetings to the faithful of the Italian language, offering best wishes to all that the new year might be peaceful and fruitful of every desired good. May you be proclaimers in today's society of the good news recited by the angels at Bethlehem. My thoughts go out, finally, as usual, to the elderly, the young, the sick, and to newlyweds. Live out the new year as a precious gift, committing yourselves to building your life in the light of the truth, which the incarnate Word came to bring to earth. And now the Holy Father will lead us in the recitation of the Our Father in Latin and give us his blessing.
Pater noster,
qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra.
Pane nostrum quotidianum da nobis,
et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem,
sed libera nos a malo. Domino hoviscum,
et in spiritu tuo,
sin nome Domini benedictum, aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini,
qui fece il cielo e la terra.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
And that was the blessing of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. And with that blessing, we conclude the live-streamed broadcast of the Pope's weekly general audience from the library of the Apostolic Palace. We do invite you to visit the Vatican News web portal, our Facebook page, Instagram account, Twitter account, and YouTube accounts for coverage of today's audience and for other Vatican and world news. My name is Christopher Wells. It has been a great joy and pleasure to provide the English language texts of this audience for you today. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to thank all of the technicians who made this broadcast possible and all of you for joining us today. Praise be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.